as 20 years of US's unlawful occupation of Afghanistan ends with its hasty and irresponsible withdrawal, once again a strong feeling against the US war on terror started within the intelligentsia and academia of Pakistan. There is a strong sense that the whole rhetoric of war on terror was in reality never intended to combat terrorism, but in fact a pretext orchestrated by US to pursue its imperialistic designs and ambitions.
I think the Americans were telling one thing to the American public, to the media, and to the world, and it was a different strategic goal behind it. It appears their goals also kept on changing. Attack on the Kabul airport basically makes it very obvious that the US counter-terror, anti-terror operations in Afghanistan have not been a huge success, given the fact that they have made such a song and dance about their operation.
I am here to point out that when President Biden says that the war was over after Osama bin Laden's death, then who is responsible for staying almost 10 years in Afghanistan, and what was the legitimate right of their forces to be there, and who is responsible for the casualties which took place, the mother of all bombs were used, the daisy cutters, etc. Of course, it was not at all war on terror, because if it was war on terror, then why the hell the whole bloody world is suffering from terrorism?
And the whole world knows that the United States had hundreds and perhaps thousands of contractors, civilian contractors, many of whom were actually US citizens. They were small companies, they were security companies, they were private contractors. And I am afraid that very large chunk of that $1.5 trillion has actually been absorbed by the US companies and contractors, and a very large sum of money has gone into the corruption of the Kabul regime, and the money once again has siphoned back into California and into London and into Dubai, and it hasn't really been spent into Afghanistan.
One of the key aspects being critically and objectively contested in Pakistan is US's narrative of installing Western-style democracy and democratic values in other countries. This forceful imposition of your own values over others against the will of the people without considering the respective ground realities is itself absolutely contradictory to the spirit of democracy and is being regarded as cultural imperialism in Pakistan.